in economics and or management. The first letter inaugural lecture was delivered by Professor Christola Olutula on 26 April 2001, titled Entrepreneurship for Economic Development. The second was delivered by Professor Aru Abiola on 7 July 2009, titled Management in Ancient and Modern Civilization. Both inaugural lectures were delivered by professors in the General Studies Unit of the School of Sciences. This inaugural lecture is intended to complement the effort of the past inaugural lecturers on agricultural production, mining and explosives, mathematics and faith, water rock association, wheat and rock, monkey and apes, biofiber waste, and among others, which have dominated inaugural lectures in this university in the last 10 years. Which, according to one 1996 and again 2015, studied the mutual adaptation between science, technology, and financial discipline in the middle. In a broader perspective, the US Method 2009 proposed a study of science and technology finance dealing with financial instruments, financial institutions, financial policies, and financial service systems, innovative arrangement, comprehensive government, enterprise, market, society, and similar institutions that provide financial resources. Mr. First Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, this 99th inaugural lecture delivered on June 12th is symbolic for historical reasons. First, June 12th marks the day that Nigeria had an election that was globally adjudged the most credible in the country. So, Mr. First Chancellor, on June 12th, I stand. Second, by my mathematical transposition of the date, the election was incidentally annulled on June 21. Thirdly, by defined arrangement, June 21 probably matched by that day. The choice of my discipline and career was also defined. I was born and grew up in a job in the local government area of Ogun State, Nigeria. My parents were fish merchants, and they engaged the children in out of category and doing fishing business. The orientation influenced my choice was the commercial class in the secondary school. And my first set of classes in economics, accounting and commerce, beautiful concepts of money were discussed. This further influenced my decision in 1986 to study banking and finance at the then Ondo State University at Ogun. Incidentally, during the period, I discovered a paper that asserted that only 3 men in the world can save or seek a nation without firing a gun. I was curious about this paper. I was intrigued to find out the 3 men were a contact, a banker, and an economist. I felt something about, and I made up my mind that I would be among these 3 powerful people. Not with intention to seek an economy, but to contribute to scholarship and galvanize economic growth. So that is the goal. The dream came true. And today, I'm standing before this August Assembly on June 12th to deliver my inaugural lecture. And I pray to you with my research effort over the years. For over 23 years, my research focus has been on the areas of entrepreneurial finance, public sector finance, financial management, business management, and economic sustainability. Therefore, this long-term interest has influenced the choice of my topic, finance, entrepreneurship, institutions, the triple helix for Nigeria's economic growth. The triple helix is a model which provides new ideas concerning the interaction between prosperity components for societal growth and development. The inaugural lecture is therefore structured as follows. After this introductory section, we have conceptual discourse on finance, entrepreneurship, and institutions, overview of Nigerian economy, my contribution to scholarship, the triple helix for Nigerian economic growth, conclusions, and recommendations. Conceptual discourse. In the analytical appraisal of any phenomenon, it is appropriate to elucidate some key concepts related to such a phenomenon prior to actual discussion. Let me therefore unpack the 3 components that are germane to the understanding of this lecture. The components are finance, entrepreneurship, and institution. Finance. Finance is generally defined as the art and science of managing money. Broadly speaking, it describes the art of mobilizing and channeling money from the surplus economic unit to the deficit economic unit for productive investment, Obamuyi 2009A. In recent times, financial transactions have been influenced by globalization, liberalization, financialization, and internationalization of finance, creating ample platform for individuals, business, and government to interact and change ideas on funding opportunities. It's also interesting to note that finance occupies unique moral and spiritual dimension in the lives of human beings. Mr. First Chancellor, please permit me to present some of your proverbs and peace saying, encapsulated the sacred importance of according to father.
Prepared for another round of financial crisis between January 2022 and
If not well managed, this may lead to a recession that will take longer in order to recover. The action to be taken must recognize the fact that Nigerian macroeconomics is most of the time defined no economic geography. This perverted behavior can be seen in the trend of inflation and interest rates during the period of recession. For example, inflation, which was expected to reduce during the period of recession, moved up from 12% in March 2016 to 17.26% in March 2017, thereby contradicting known economic theory. Similarly, the maximum lending rate during the period also shows a rising trend from 26.93% in March 2016 to 30.18% in March 2017, contradicting economic theory. Therefore, in the future, Nigeria must address the paradox of having a majority of our citizens living below the poverty line and the means of abundant natural resources. Economy refers to the coexistence of past natural resources and extreme poverty as a resource cost. The extraction of natural resources causes significant discomfort rather than bringing benefits. The study by Ebusu et al. 2015, using the factor to regressive modeling approach, established the existence of diseases in Nigeria with the neglect of the agriculture due to sudden rainfall from oil. Thus, the seas is a situation where the growth in national income from natural resources extraction damages other sectors of the economy, sources of the question of the natural sector. Contribution to scholarship. Mr. First Chancellor, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to situate my research effort in three areas: finance and economic growth, entrepreneurship and economic growth, institutional performance and economic growth. These segments of relations are well captured in finance growth theories, entrepreneurship research-based theory, and institutional efficiency theory. I further propose the adoption of triple helix model to investigate the balance of interaction of finance, entrepreneurship, and institutions, which are germane to contribute to economic growth, finance and economic growth, supply chain and demand following. The controversy in finance literature is whether the development of financial institutions receive and hence play an active role in economic development, which we call supply chain finance, or whether it passively adjusts to the growth of the recent, which we call demand following finance. Accordingly, three schools of thought are considered in literature. One, those that consider finance as a critical element of growth. Two, those that regard finance as a critical important factor in growth. Three, those that concentrate on the potential negative impact of finance on growth. In November 2012, a graduate consultancy test was used on a tax series data from 1973 to 2009 to test the direction of the relationship between financial development and economic growth in the country. The result of the study showed that there existed a bidirectional causality between economic growth and financial development. This implied that both growth and finance exert influence on each other. In recent study by Akure 2015 and Obamuyi and Fallow in 2018, financial development was found to be critical to economic growth of Nigeria. Financial inclusion and economic growth. Financial inclusion is the delivery of an extensive range of financial services at affordable costs that are appropriate to the needs of all segments of the population. According to the Central Bank of Nigeria, 2012, financial inclusion is achieved when adults in Nigeria have access to a broad range of formal financial services that meet their needs at an affordable cost. From the above conceptualization, financial inclusion assumes that there are level playing ground for all categories of people to access financial services without hindrance. However, the challenge of financial inclusion has been established in Nigeria for the women, youth, unemployed, and people living with disability. Obama in Asoka for 2014, Obama in 2016, Obama in 2017. For instance, Obama in 2016 found that people living with disability face financial exclusion as follows. One, people living with disability without figures are not operating bank accounts due to inability to enroll for bank verification number BVN. Bank started CPF policy to open accounts for people with BVN, which is not feasible for people without figures. Two, banks have no special credit program for people living with disability. All customers are subjected to the same credit appraisal by all banks and no finance banks alike. Therefore, the study called for financial intermediary strategy that will channel financial resources to all people that have potential and the types of resources provided should be designed to influence their investment decisions. Policy scheme and economic growth. The United States of America Securities and Exchange Commission defined policy scheme as an investment fraud which involves payment of supposed to current investor for funds paid by French investor. Based on the mode of operation, it is reasonable to view Ponzi scheme as money doubling scheme and participants in the scheme and therefore be regarded as regulators who are voting for good force. This is so good to go to, and this rapid and unrealistic computation of the financial scheme have serious consequences for investors and national economy. Obamuyi et al. 2018 identified 105 project schemes in operation in Nigeria as of 2017, with the 5 patronal schemes being the FM Nigeria, the Twinkers, Open Santa, Ask Charity, and Get Help Worldwide. Our study also identified 5 most influencing factors for participation in project schemes as friends' recommendation, expected benefits, economic situation, ease of daily funds, and get rich big syndrome. However, many of the project schemes have been learned globally. And loss of fairness to many people the world over, and hence do not contribute to economic growth. Regrettably, the founder of FM Financial Traffic was reported to have died of heart attack. Yeah, what happened to the followers? Based on the finding, our study recommended decisive action by the government to stop the recurrence of the scheme, while participants were advised to always afford such money dummy scheme and seek other alternative investment like money capital market instrument that are deeply secure and guaranteed favorable returns, entrepreneurship and economic growth, accessibility and management of finance. Our studies, Obamuyi 2008, Olutula and Obamuyi 2008, identify the factors that have constrained finance to SMEs both on the demand and supply side. On the demand side, we find that firms were reluctant to obtain loans from demand because of high interest rates and stringent lending policies. On the supply side, we found that banks were constrained due to poor credit worthiness, moral hazard, and risk associated with business. Obamuyi 2011 examined the effect of access to credit through macro credit institutions on the entrepreneurial performance. The study found that only 42.69% of loans granted by the United States macro credit agency in 2007 were repaid, giving a default rate of 57.31%. The reason for the low repayment rate were poor credit culture of the scheme managed by the public sector and the attitude of Nigerians toward public funds. This is national aid we must share for it. The study concluded that for SME to contribute to economic growth, policy makers should improve on the design of macro credit in the country. However, Obamuyi 2011 found the higher performance of 92.93% for those granted to SME by banks in Ondo State. That is, banks perform at much higher levels than macro credit scheme. In Obamuyi 2011, Obamuyi 2012, Obamuyi 2014, it was asserted that the powerful credit market and lender efficiency allowed the powerful politically or the disbalance of credit or what you want to have access to larger loans and they tend to get away with credit money or become willful defaulters. Basically, the small business holders are more vulnerable and do not have the loss of willful default as they are allowed to account at any sign of default. Huge entrepreneurship in Nigeria. The emphasis on youth entrepreneurship is critical, given that Nigeria has a population which is heavily skewed towards the younger generation, most of whom are either unemployed or unemployed. This critically demonstrates that the slogan, not too young to run for political offices, should be replaced with not too young to run businesses in order to accelerate economic growth. The Nigerian team of Global Entrepreneurial Scheme Monitor, GEM, of which I'm a member, undertook a survey of young Nigerians in 2012-2013, and the study found that the proportion who could be transferred as potential entrepreneurs were very high. In fact, in that study, it was discovered that Nigeria led the whole world in entrepreneurial spirit. However, only 40% said that they intended to start a business themselves, while 22% were in the process of starting out on their own. However, financial issues form the least of the setting dissuading young people from becoming entrepreneurs. Over 80% of funding came from either the entrepreneur's personal savings or those of their family. Surprisingly, only 0.7% of the youth in Nigeria have knowledge of numerous public government schemes in the country. That shows the place of awareness. In Obamuyi 2017, using GEM data from 2012 to 2014 to study startup financing and expenditure for growth for young and older entrepreneurs in 10 sub-Saharan African countries, the study revealed that young entrepreneurs have higher growth expectations than old ones It is all demonstrated that for every annual increase in age from 18 to 24 years, expectations for growth are increased by 3.4 percentage points. The youth are exposed to new technology and hence more innovative than the older population. The study recommended that the government should segment the population into groups and identify their regular financial needs and their business growth expectation in order to enhance entrepreneurship development, entrepreneurship and socio-economic growth. Obama in 2012 6 examined the reason for the poor economic development in the coastal area of Ondo State and cities like Nigeria. Despite the presence of rich natural resources, the study revealed that the financial predicament of the people of Nigeria emanated from the exploration and exploitation activities of private companies operating in the region, which had destroyed the means of livelihood, causing poverty, lack of access to finance, and poor infrastructure. The study recommended that the government and the intervention agencies must provide financial resources and facilitate investment, efficient equipment, and infrastructure development for sustainable fishing, business, and economic well-being of the people in the area. Institutional performance and economic growth. If there was a World Cup for fraud, Nigeria would always be in the finals. Mr. Fashion Silverson. The above comment was entered with former Executive Director, well served by the director, as reported in Honor 1987. Whether the statement is true or false is not important, but the point is that this is the perception of my people here and abroad, Obamuyi 1989. Similarly, the frustrating statement of David Cameron that Nigeria is fantastically corrupt can be alluded to the magnitude of fraud cases reported in Nigeria in recent times, and these cases then pretend to reveal that fraud is prevalent in the country, institutions of government and economic growth. The Nigerian Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, confirming the high level of corruption in the institution of government in Nigeria, said as follows: all the institutions of government, AMNIM, the executive, legislation, and the judiciary are corrupt. What we need is serious reorientation. That was why the present federal government is intervening. Because if we refuse, every president of the country will fail, and we must act fast and deal with this situation as quickly as possible. Indeed, Adeyemi and Obamuyi in 2010 had argued that the high level of corruption in Nigeria had been aided by the conspiratorial relationship between political appointees and accounting officers. Obamuyi and Obamuyi in 2018 examined the effect of corruption for the growth of Nigeria and establish that corruption is an undesirable effect on the Nigerian economy. Based on the foregoing, there has been for a prosopographical approach to the history of the people in charge of our public institution in Nigeria. Prosopography emphasizes the fact that human societies and institutions are better studied and fully understood if attempts are made to understand the work value system, orientation, background, and the pedigree of the leaders that are saddled on the task of decision-making in such society. Point in time. Few from the foregoing, it is evidently clear that the country should align with the argument of late Professor Thomas Adeoyelabo, the former Director General of Psychiatric Hospital Aru, Nigeria, who has reported in the media, advocated that everybody who has aspires to political leadership should have his head examined by a psychiatrist. In recent times, in Nigeria, facilities like ceiling, rooms, farmland, have been used by some prominent citizens of the country to serve as funds for their suspicious and unexplained work. We have serious examples in our days. About in 2018, investigated the rationale behind people, government keeping large amount of money in a professional basis in this era of electronic money. The study found that factors like maladaptive and inefficient financial system, inconveniences associated with depositing and withdrawing money from the bank, electronic card fraud, the passive or friendly attitude of bank staff, unexplained sources of fraud emanating from corruption, and attempt to circumvent government regulation were responsible for such unholy practices. The study concluded that the fraud outside the banking system have rendered the central bank monetary policy ineffective, with concomitant adverse effect on inclusive economic growth. Perhaps more noteworthy is the report of a nationwide survey conducted by National Bureau of Statistics 2017 in partnership with the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, which indicated that police officers have the highest prevalence of bribery in Nigeria, 46.4%, followed by prosecutors, 33.0%, and judges, magistrates, 31.5%. The implication is that the public institutions that are entrusted with the responsibility of enforcing against bribery and corruption are fantastically corrupt. The problem in Friday was that out of 137 participating countries, Nigeria was ranked 130 with respect to trust public, trust in politicians, 124 with respect to irregular payments and bribe, and 120 with respect to wastefulness of government spending. Similarly, a comparative analysis undertaken in November 2018 with respect to corruption ranking among selected countries in sub-Saharan Africa indicated that Nigeria leads many of the sub-Saharan African countries in corruption, as the country ranks 148 out of 180 participating countries. Mr. First Chancellor, sir, the high level of corruption in Nigeria has adversely affected the country economic growth. And in the near future, the country will be vulnerable to socio-economic crisis and hence be yourself for everybody, including the rich. The rich also carry. That's the story. The undesirable situation calls for sober reflection on the part of corrupt elements to society to prevent the situation described by the late say Chief Obama Bawolo and as a producer. The pursuit of wealth is not a bad thing itself, because without the food and comfort which wealth provides, land will be penurious matter. But always remember that any wealth accumulated on a selfish basis at the expense of the state, in defiance of social justice, can be paid in this organized society in which everybody will eat everybody. No one person can be safe. The triple headings for Nigerian economic growth. Mr. First Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, for Nigeria to achieve inclusive economic growth, I propose the adoption of triple headings model theorized by Eko Wing and leader Dr. 2000, with modification as shown in the figures. 5. The study by Eko Wing and leader Dr. 2000 was based on the interaction between academic, industry, and government to foster economic and social development. And a deep implementation of the triple headings is meant to let the component interact and change those initiatives and rising sciences as well as bottom-up and top-down economics 2008. My inaugural lecture was motivated to use the triple headings model to demonstrate the interaction between finance, entrepreneurship, and decisions and their contribution to economic growth in Nigeria. Finance, entrepreneurship, interaction. This is a known fact that the government over the years has embarked on many entrepreneurial policies, but most of them were maladapted, misdirected, to the extent that in most cases they benefited the initiators rather than the target audience. Although the policy of introducing entrepreneurship study in all higher institutions in welcome development, the financial backing is much more important to ensure that the objectives of the policy are ultimately realized, as most young school leavers lack startup capital, Obamuyi 2017. In fact, some of the entrepreneurship policy and program in Nigeria lack transparency and were designed to stop political growth rather than genuinely promoting growth. The inconsistency in government policy probably explains why Nigeria was ranked 106 out of 107 participating countries in terms of transparency in government policy making. Deriving from the foregoing, Obamuyi and Luma in 2018 found that the poor formulation of government entrepreneurship policy and program in Nigeria negatively affected their performance. As well as figure 6, the objective of entrepreneurial programs should be job creation, reduction in poverty, enhance financial inclusion, and improve public sector performance abroad to generate inclusive economic growth, which ultimately require optimal funding. Thus, in Obamuyi and Nairobi 2018, the importance of finance for improved entrepreneurship and economic development was amply demonstrated. The summary of the foregoing is that the growth in the economy should be ramped up with sound government entrepreneurial financial policy with genuine intention for promoting inclusive growth. Finance, institutions, interaction. Total recovery from the present economic quagmire demands that the country strategically address the challenges of social building and the reckless behavior that featureless and uncommitted leaders through unrealistic budget cutting and implementation abstraction, financial discipline, corruption, and conflicting policies. The slow pace of growth, therefore, is an evidence of misguided resource allocation and wasteful spending on the part of the institutions of government without recourse to saving and investment, which are necessary impetus to economic growth. Institutional inefficiency has limited the impact of finance on the economy, Obamuyi 2002, Obamuyi and Fakwe 2016. Thus, there is need for synergy among the big ideas of government to build strong institutions and strong leaders who should all drive in the same direction. Institutions, entrepreneurship, interaction. The interaction between the institutions of government and entrepreneurial activity depends on the government gender relationship role and policy towards entrepreneurship. For entrepreneurial activity to triumph, there is need for investment and accountability in decisions of government and deliberate commitment on the part of the government to fight institutional corruption in the country at the year of November 2010. A cursory look into the activities of institutions reveal pathetic situations of the level of investment and how poorly these institutions have performed in the past. The Nigerian First President, Professor Yemi Osman, suddenly captured the situation as follows. The question of state building and the capacity of the state on its most important role, which is security and ensuring justice and the rule of law, is often threatened because we simply have not invested enough in the institution that make this happen. This is from number 2 and the country. The FAGO statement further confirmed that our institutions are weak and cannot support the type of investment required for transformation entrepreneurship in the global region. Therefore, it is imperative to match financial policy with efficient public decision and transformational entrepreneurship for inclusive economic growth. Strength of the interaction. The triple helix model, also depicted in figure 7, is expected to generate a network system of interactive spiral of the components for economic growth. Therefore, the strength of the interaction between finance, entrepreneurship, and decision depends on which of the components is the driving force in the frame. However, the trend towards transformational entrepreneurship the world over to address the problem of unemployment, underemployment, and economic system has carved a bigger role for institutional development in the growth process. For over 23 years of my research, I found that strong institutions are important for building a modern academic economic system. Obama 2002, and the AMNIM Obama 2010, Obama 2018. Institutions act as an embedded platform that provide opportunity to innovate and drive entrepreneurial activities and all the available financial resources. Mr. Fashion Zillow, sir, it is not a doubt that Nigeria over the years has produced strong leaders like Chief of Government Bawolo, Dr. Nadia Sibu, Aladi Abuba Kataba, Tafa Balewa, and even our Fashion Zillow, who is a strong one too. And great entrepreneurs like Chief MP Abiola, Aladji Ali Dangote, Mrs. Folon Solakita, that's the richest woman in Africa, and Dr. Mike Adelman. But no strong institutions have been entrenched, which have made institutions to be subjected to the whims and caprices of the people in authority. In fact, most of the institutions lack a better structure that can checkmate the excesses of individual and group. The importance of strong institutions was famously summarized by Barack Obama in his address to the Ghanaian Parliament. Africa does not need strong men, it needs strong institutions. Inasmuch as one agrees with Barack Obama, for inclusive economic growth, both strong leaders and strong institutions are necessary in all sectors of the national economy, be it politics, be it education, everywhere, for efficient and effective management of the country resources. In order to avoid a mere insight into the literature, in the recommendation of the Triple Helix, Obama in 2018 carried out an econometric analysis of the impact of the interaction of the three components on Nigeria's inclusive economic growth. The empirical evidence presented in the study confirmed the benefit of synergistic interactive behavior of the three components of the Triple Helix in the growth process. Conclusion. Mr. Fashion Silosa, ladies and gentlemen, in the last couple of minutes, I've established that the three major strengths in the growth of any economy is the presence of financial system and structure, institutions that can provide support and embedded entrepreneurial activities that can foster economic growth. The direction of my research has been to provide extensive policy focus for the government on how best to grow the Nigerian economy. In the process, I've applied the triple helix model and other ways to explicate the interaction and rotation of finance, entrepreneurship and institutions to the nation's economic growth. What is required is the investment and development of technologies that provide the fertile for creativity and innovation. The synergy of the three components will assist to reverse the situation where government in developing countries which enrich the endowment of abundant natural resources tend to have less economic growth and poorer development outcome than countries with fewer natural resources. Recommendations. For the Nigerian economy to experience accelerated economic growth, the following recommendations are advanced. Recommendation for government and policymakers. Government should adopt the triple helix policy to tie together entrepreneurship initiative and sound financial policy with increased overall institutional efficiency. Two, there's need for the government to develop public sector entrepreneurial policy with genuine intention for promoting growth. Three, government must embark on institutional reform by moving from romanticism to pragmatism through healthy investment in public institutions to enhance their efficiency. Those who be appointed as the heads and boss of MDM should undergo a battery of mental examination and must be people who know their own knowledge and with deep knowledge of the MDM into which over which they are to be appointed. Policymakers have plans to increase startup financial support for young entrepreneurs, especially those aged 18 to 24 years, to accelerate growth. Government should establish a statutory unit, such as entrepreneurial finance support agency, in the tertiary education transfer to provide startup capital for all desiring graduate entrepreneurs to solve their initial capital needs. There must be aggressive technological advancement by government in the areas of financial technology, information technology, farming technology, among others, which will synergize the balance of interaction of the three components of the triple pillars for inclusive economic growth. Recommendation to monetary policy, based on financial central bank intervention. Both the formal and informal financial system should be integrated in the design and implementation of financial inclusion program to cater for the various categories of businesses and people, including women, youth, unemployed, underemployed, and people living with disability. Number two, there is need to enhance the effectiveness and efficiency of the financial system by increasing the depth and the breadth of financial instruments to encourage savings and investment, which are germane to economic growth. Recommendation to the Ministry of Education, National University Commission, and higher institutions like FUTA. Financial literacy dealing with investment and financial decisions should be introduced into the curricula of all Nigerian universities. This will offer graduates the opportunity to effectively manage their personal and corporate resources for wealth creation. It will assist leaders to appreciate the efficient management of country resources. Number two, academics should incorporate entrepreneurship into the method of teaching at all levels of program, undergraduate and postgraduate, irrespective of the discipline, department, school, in order to improve student cognitive entrepreneurial skills. This presupposes that lecturers are trained in the art and science of entrepreneurship in their delivery system to orientate their mindset. It is expected, Mr. Fashion, that the Federal University of Technology and Program will take the lead in this direction. Science and Business Marketing Research Center should be established to assist universities in the commercialization of research and food of academics to serve as good between industry, government, and academic community. Four, universities should establish student entrepreneurship development academies to provide an opportunity for students to interact through seminars, workshops, bootcamping, and competitions to sharpen their entrepreneurial mindset. Centers should explore the diverse needs of students and provide opportunities for those that want to establish their own business for graduation. Five, research scheme for technological finance and entrepreneurship that will enhance transformational entrepreneurial university to be self-sustaining and financially independent of government supervision should be established. Universities should stop money to Abuja to look for money. Universities should have a program that will generate funds to sustain themselves and even then in government. Recommendation to the private sector. There's a need by the operators in the private sector to afford the diversion of funds to unproductive ventures against the purpose for which funds were approved. Number two, the private sector should seek timely and relevant information to improve their knowledge of various funding opportunities to meet their financial needs and reasonable cost. Three, the private sector needs to expand their ownership structure, expand their management capability, and improve their record keeping in order to make them attractive to lenders. Acknowledgement. Mr. Fashion, sir, ladies and gentlemen, I'm grateful to God, the all-sufficient, omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent, who has consistently provided a sheet over my family, over my church, and over my world. Truly, he is the God of the beginning, the God of the middle, and the God of the ending. The Lord is perfect in all his ways. I'm highly indebted to my parents, most reverend Apostle Julius Obamuyi, and I am blessed to call you Obamuyi, in Jitola, both of blessed men. They were led at my birth to give a name that reminds me of the supremacy of God. And that Tomola, you see, who said that Tomola. They also taught their children the importance of hard work and laying our feet on the path of the Lord. My prayer is that if there are many heavens, God should place them in the best ones. I appreciate the contribution of my resident sibling, Ginyanu Obamuyi, Mrs. Olamide Ebori, Mrs. Obamuyi, our minister, and Reverend Olosun Obamuyi. Especially acknowledge the support received from our siblings who have gone to be with the Lord, especially Ginyanu Josie, Ebori Obamuyi, who sponsored my second grant, University Education. I also appreciate my other siblings, especially Tele Obamuyi. I appreciate my uncles and their family, Professor and Mrs. Fola, Mrs. Miji, Chief and Mrs. F.A. Bitumi, Mr. and Mrs. Fred Obamuyi, Mr. and Mrs. S.F. Chitola, and others from the local government. I'm thankful to my in-laws, Reverend Enoch Yosabidone and Mrs. Esther Peter Yosabidone, who's a blessed member. I also appreciate the contribution of Mrs. Cecilia Legui, a blessed member. Mr. and Mrs. Tuti Yosabidone, Mr. and Mrs. E. Adeyemi, and others too numerous for me to mention here because of time. I appreciate all my teachers at the school, at the St. Paul's and Air Primary School, the day of our hosting, who provided the unbeatable foundation for my career. I'm also thankful to all my teachers at the General School in Bogota, for those in particular, late Prince Leo Matua, Principal, Chief Pio Ayomi, First Principal, Chief I.A. Demen, and others for the discipline committed in life of the student. I sincerely appreciate all my lecturers at Blue State University, now at the State University, where I earned my first degree. Furthermore, I'm grateful to my lecturer at the University of Lagos, the University of First Choice, Nation's Pride, where I have had my master's and for the opportunity to be groomed by seasoned professors. I'm highly indebted to all my lecturers at the Federal University of Technology, Akure, through my MBA and PhD program. Special appreciation goes to my PhD professor, Professor Gigi Olutola, Professor Babis, CEO of the University of Lagos. My warmest regard to my academic mentors, starting with Professors Fola Ebisemiju, A.T. Ujo, Femi Mimiko, A.G. Daramola, G.T. Olutola, A.E. Akelo, and Dr. Akelo, for their support and employment in my career development. I sincerely appreciate the support received from my past vice chancellor, from the past vice chancellor of Adekunle Adeleke University of Bagogo, Professors Akin Akidoyemi, W.A. Mimiko, Fushu Akele, and Femi Mimiko, who announced my leadership and professorship. I was privileged to acquire the necessary administrative experience, having served under all of them for 12 years as head of department and later as the director of DKT's and International Program Office for 2 years. I'm thankful to the current Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Ekele, who is a long-time friend and a brother, and all the principal officers of the University, Mr. M.S. Ayeho and Mrs. Fio Olobu. I'm also grateful to the following professors at Adekunle University, I.R. Adai, Olubi Naike, Yemisani Borale, Nire Tidu Yemi, Fendi Zoluwa Tadwe, Yomi Dinaki, Nia Fokumole, Siye Naramola, Siwa Fulwe, Sola Olofe, Besa Kino Wono, Oluka Adia Falami, Oluka Ebuto, and Fio Olubeko. Also, I appreciate Dr. Esu Adilagu, HOD Banking and Finance, and all academic and non-academic members of staff of the university for their support through my service at the university. I express my sincere appreciation to the past chancellors of FUTA, particularly Professors Peter Adini, Adebisi Balogun, and Adebisi Daramola, for their foresight at establishing and not maturing the School of Management Technology to maturity. I'm grateful to the incoming past chancellor of FUTA, Professor Joseph Adiola Fuambe, for his unstinting support to SMART, and for allowing the lecture to hold today. I appreciate other principal officers, Professor O. Arayila, Professor P.K. Obutude, Mr. Harry Arifalo, Mr. E.A. Koreshek, and Dr. E.U. Benamosi. I appreciate the working relationship with the following professors and colleagues at the Committee of Kings, FUTA, Edward Tiwale, who is the chairman of the Committee of Kings, O.K. Koriko, T.T. Amos, I.B. Kassim, P.A. Nkansheku, A.S. Adiabu, O.S. Adiwale, and Peter Onibi. I also acknowledge the support received from the following professors in FUTA, T.L. Akibogu, S.U. Akedini, P.A. Burishadi, Z.U. Akafoso, J.A. Padabiro, J.O. Okuru. brother, big year, is T.O. okay, incidentally, we sat together in 1990 in the wedding. And so when I went to FUTA, I met him, we were so happy. That's the time we are just professor of care in FUTA. And that is I've had a letter to all members of staff in the School of Management Technology FUTA for the privilege to be elected as the first substantive dean of the school since 2015 and presently for the second time, having been re-elected in August 2017 for another term of 2 years. I'm thankful to the past acting deans of the school, professors E.T.O. Lutula, Z.O. Obafunso, and E.E. Okoko. I appreciate the contribution of all professors, especially Professor T.O. Asawu, Professor Ariwa Abiola, Akarakiri, M.O.W., S.O.U.U., T.M.A. Fisheri. Also, I'm thankful to Drs. A.M. Lawa, K.T. Tarabosi, T.O. Fango, P.S.O. Lula, U.N., Lokiri, S.O. Samuel O.K.V.O., Asikowu, O.K.O.U., and M.S.T. I also recognize the contribution of the past and present of these Drs. K.T. O.P.B. of Blessed Memory, A.T. Dada, and A.O. Anibodi, as well as the chairman and members of the school committees and the entire members of staff of SMART. I'm also thankful to the following academics at the State University, Professor K. Elo Universitet, Professor P. O. Oladele, and Dr. S. O. Adeosi, and others for their support. Special appreciation goes to the SLC, Professor Bola Akai, the Deputy Governor of the University, Funcional Exam, the Honorable Commissioner, Pastor Emmanuel Basan, and others. Equally, I appreciate Honorable Locke Aida to our Dodo State Commissioner for the Board of NDC. He was here in the morning when he left for assignment at Port Harcourt. Honorable Barrister Gwenga Edebo, the chairman, also had exited here, and Dr. Hugh Colleby, the secretary, also had it. I hope you appreciate the real blessing from His Imperial Majesty, Oba Frederick, and the Jolo Honda, Oba Terra, the Oguru and Kawa, Paramount Ruler of the Scarp Authority, the Olubu of Igbo Kingdom, that's my Oba, Olubu Liga, and the Tabi Ogu, the Kutubu Choba Ogu, Osanama, Oba Fia, Afo, Oba Tolubu. Also, I want to thank His Royal Majesty, Oba Professor Sunday Adejimola, half the finger, seated there. I thank you for his cousin and encouragement while we are together, working together in Adejimola Adjust University. Now he's number one, the primary ruler of the kingdom. That's kind of we have appointed. I appreciate the support received from His Royal Majesty, Oba Dr. Francis Adefarakomi, Abede Ifemloi, the Olowa of the Kingdom. The Olowa created a mighty year. Olowa is declared because he is president out of the country with the Oni of Ife. So he donated a mighty building, his chief also come to the university to discuss with them. Your Royal Majesty, one thing that is certain is that with the presence of the Imperial and Royal Majesty as Royal Fathers here today, the probability of my becoming a king very soon will be addressed as His Royal Majesty of our doctor and our professor, T.O. Obamuyi, is very high. I also acknowledge the special blessing from the pastors in the Christ Apostolic Church, especially Dr. S. O. Adesilure, Regional Superintendent of Odo and Ekiti State. My gratitude also goes to all elders, ignorances, and members of CSC, okay, your GCC, Akure, and Freedom Soul. As an elder of Christ Apostle Church, I pray that we will all be careful in Jesus' name. My profound appreciation goes to Sir Chief Doctor Bode Akindele, the Paragoye of Nagala, who donated a multi-million naira building regarded as the most architecturally exciting building in FUTA, where my office as city is located. I also acknowledge the support of members of Bode Akindele Initiative, especially most Reverend K.D. Stephen Chairman, Pastor, and Mrs. J. Agwala, and Mrs. Bugola Obosan. I want to thank his Chief Doctor Rotimi Pinabo for donating a building to SMART when I approach him in his own country hometown. I'm also thankful to His Royal Majesty Air Force Marshal Lucky O'Hill Harari, that was my classmate in the MSC class in the Uniland, and Omoba Adeleke Adedoye Ganebo for donating generously to the development of SMART in my period as the dean of the school. My gratitude goes to the Academic Times, who reviewed the manuscript for their decisive comment to improve the quality of the inaugural lecture. I'm grateful to my inaugural lecture prayer team members, Professor J. Fanabino, Professor Z. O. Mafuso, Dr. A. Flower, and Mr. C. Linda. I'm very grateful to my PhD students for spending quality time together during the period of the preparation of the inaugural lecture. Where you can look at Dennis Akufola, Felix Adieva, Fugola Faloy, Sola Falabi, Grace Ryobi, and Jide Falabi. I want to thank members of the technical team for quality presentation of the lecture, especially Dr. Oluwole, Dr. F. Oluwole, and Mrs. A. O. Odafadeju, P. Asa, and Femi Oyemi, and Mr. Eliowu. I'm also grateful to the management of the university where I have served as a standard examiner from the candidates for MSc oral examination, and that includes University of Marseille and then Obafemi University. I remain grateful to the National University Commission for appointing me to serve as member of Akure team to some Nigerian university. I'm also indebted to some national and international organizations that have provided grants for my overseas trip to countries like Finland, United Kingdom, Canada, Sweden, Ireland, Ghana, Zambia, Ghana, Ethiopia, India, United States of America, among others. And the names include Tertiary Education Trust Fund, Global Entrepreneurship Monitor, Global Entrepreneurship Research Association, Canadian International Development Agency, International Development Research Center, and Swedish International Development Cooperation Agency. I appreciate all the staff of International Center for Transformational Entrepreneurship, Coventry University, United Kingdom, for nominating me to participate in the International Think Tank colloquium, and for allowing me to use their facilities and their useful suggestions during the period of the preparation of the inaugural lecture. I'm highly indebted to the African Educational Leadership Award, Mauritius, East Africa, for considering me worthy of the prestigious international award of the best professor for Coventry and Finance in Africa for 2015. I really appreciate the support of all members of the world at the award. Especially Professor Koyaoke, Provost Adeyemi, Lev Education, Dr. Bade Kwekebe, Dr. Oyefa Oyemi, Justin Emi Oyemi, and Mrs. Mayowa Adeyemi, Adeyemo, Rashid Yusuf, Tunde Ogunleye, Fayo Rajibo, Tomola Malibu, Shego Yowole, and all alumni of Ilagin High School, Gokoda, the State University, Adobe, University of Lagos, and the Federal University of Technology. I appreciate Dr. Mrs. Eo Adeyemi, Dr. Mrs. M.O. Adeyemi, Dr. Emi Mayowa, and other members of the Planning Committee for the necessary organization and logistics to work ensuring successful inaugural lecture. My appreciation also goes to the Directorate of Corporate Communication and Protocol, FUTA, for their support at all times for smart programming. I thank all my past and present students, both of my graduate and postgraduate, in all decisions that have had the opportunity to interact and share the experience. I thank the chairman and members of OKLA, Zone 2, Landlord Association, of my late house in Akure, for the brotherly love that have created conducive environment for community interaction. To my children, Abimbola, Omotola, Omolola, and Olatide, who the Lord has given me for science and wonder, I say thank you for your understanding and support. To my beautiful, beautiful, and darling one, Dickiness, Missy Odua, Beatrice, and all of you. Who God has sent to fulfill his purpose in my life, as commanded in the book of Genesis 18 and reconfirmed in the book of Proverbs 18:22. I wish to reemble my father's economy to our wives in the family. I live with me. I live to me. I live with 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 me. You have my full permission to continue to plug money for the precious things at the back of our family house, so that you continue to prepare orugbo bitter leaf soup for me. Uburu. Mr. Fasha Selos, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your presence and attention. God bless you.
wonderful presentation. Excellent. The very fortunate thing is that when you leave here, you go and eat food. His Imperial Majesty of our Professor Sonte, Adeji Bola, Abushe, the Kalan Sule of Akwila, really, highly recognize. We also recognize here in Abish, the High Chief, AO, one of the champions of Barawaki. We also have here High Chief, Akim, Balofi, the Balofi of Barawaki. High Chief, Kayobi, Ikotu, Shao of Barawaki. High Chief, J.O. Kolawale, Ashanov of Ibarawi. The Honorable Commissioner of Environment is around, so we recognize Honorable Fushua Esau. We also have the Special Advisor of Education, Dr. Wubi Ilawole. Of course, we have Honorable Rubega Edema, Chairman of Somali. We have so many professors who are present here. Professor N.A. Ireti, Uyi Mimi, AAU. Dr. Elaine Moya Timothy, AAUA. And we have our own father here, Bashar Sende Arugofa, Kaya State. We have Professor J.A. Oloyede, Professor of Banking and Finance, and former council member at the State University. We have Dr. M.O. Okay, HOD Banking and Finance at the State University. Dr. Ruyika Ojedoku, AAUA. Mr. Gabriel Olorunlinke, AAUA. Mrs. Olalewa, AAUA. Femi State James, Akure FUTA Partnership. Front row, we have Professor T.A. Ofuya, former Vice Chancellor of Western University. Prince Adekule Adeshida, former University Librarian FUTA. Mr. A.W.O. Atoye, former Acting Registrar, FUTA. We have Pastor and Mrs. Yomi Akinola, CAC, Obidong. As a professor, sir, Pastor, you're welcome. Pastor Alatide Julius, CAC, Obidong. Pastor Tisplay of King, CAC, Obidong. Pastor and Mrs. Abenda, the Pool of God District, Adoekiti. Evangelist Engineer John, Obitude, CAC, Obeygon. Evangelist Mrs. Bimbo, Tayo, CAC, Obeygon. Pastor Isaac, Owoyemi, CAC, Obeygon. Pastor Guru, CAC, okay, go. Pastor Adeniro, CAC, okay, go. Many professors, like I said, Professor Shola Olorunfemi, representing the Vice Chancellor of the University of Ibadan. Professor Benson Akinwominu, Director of Academic Planning, Adekunle Adeshi University. Professor Anthony Akilo, Department of Economics of Afrika Awolowo University. Professor of Mrs. Ogubo Debe, Adekunle Adeshi University. Mrs. Olubumi Olubu Bosa, Adekunle Adeshi University. Professor Olukoya Ogan, the Provost Adeyemi College of Education. represented by Dr. Bani Ibu Jubel. We have also our mayor in our presence, Mrs. Remileku Aki Mawolu, from Adokuna Agasu University. The members of the family, our inaugural lecturer's uncle, Mr. Igitola Shem Molibishu. And then the children of our inaugural lecturer, Mrs. Abimola Obamuyi. Ms. Omotola Obamuyi. Master Omolola Obamuyi. Alatide Obamuyi. And of course, we have the beautiful Daddy Dickiness, the Missy Oluwa Beatrice Obamuyi. Aka Aya Obamuyi. The distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I've also called sight of Barrister Ebi Sheili, former Commissioner for Environment in the State, who welcomed you, sir. An ATM card belonging to Abelusi Oluwakemi was found. If it is yours, come with irrefutable proof of ownership to that side of the hall. The ATM card belonging to Abelusi Oluwakemi lost but has been found. The guests of the inaugural lecturer, royal fathers, government functionaries, professors, and senior members of staff of FUTA and AUE are invited to a sumptuous dinner at the multipurpose hall. Kukuru will also be served. After now, only the leaders of our academic community, as well as the wife of the inaugural lecturer and one or two persons that have been notified, will be allowed at the roving venue. If you want to see the inaugural lecturer, permit him to leave the roving venue before saying it. We will rise now and I will announce where the students will be fetted after now. We will rise for the FUTA as well as the national anthems.
Thank you. to leave the auditorium. We will remain standing.
Exist, that's the
minutes for my